Okay. Anyway, guys, again, I want to welcome you guys to our class. And I just want to tell you that I hope you find Ramadan enjoyable this year, inshallah. We stopped last time right here. All right. We want to discuss, I guess it's this section, right? Yeah, that's what I thought would be important to discuss. Let me see. No, there's something before. I think on page 34, there was something that we had to talk about, probably. Let's take a look and see if that's, if 34 is worth discussing. So, we did not discuss this, right, guys? Have you ever pulled an all-nighter? So, have you ever pulled an all-nighter? Did we discuss this, guys? Just remind me, say yes or no. Hello? No, we have not. I just remembered. Okay, because of pop quizzes, we did not discuss pop quizzes or any of that. So, have you ever, we talked about this, have you ever pulled an all-nighter? What does it mean to pull an all-nighter? Who can remind us? Who can remind us what it means to pull an all-nighter? Rowan?
To stay all night studying for like studying in general.
Yeah. And usually, let me say, you do it because your exams are, at the, as they say, at the doorstep, right? So if no, why not? Why haven't, okay, who can give us a no, no as an answer? Have you ever pulled an all-nighter that you stayed up all night? Rowan?
I actually forgot my hand, but I have actually once pulled an all-nighter. It was in school. Like I've been so busy during the day that I didn't get to study for like my upcoming quiz, like exam that was on like the second day. So I had to pull an all-nighter and go to sleep very and go to school very, very sleepy. But luckily the day passed. Like
Good.
I didn't get a good grade.
Yeah, it's always better not to really do that, to get some sleep. Like even if you
Yeah.
stay up for some time, I wouldn't go for the for doing an all-nighter. Just because you won't feel, your body will feel tense and tired the next day, and probably you won't even perform well. So I would recommend going to sleep for at least 2 or 3 hours, no matter what. But not sleeping at all would be not my recommendation. All right. Yeah, good job,
Yes.
Rowan. Although I've done it before as a student, we do it because we're scared that, you feel guilty if you haven't covered the material, let me say, and and you're still you, and you go to sleep because sleeping is all about resting, right? And you feel that you only deserve to rest when you've finished probably studying, right? That's how I felt, at least. Who has never pulled an all-nighter? Who has never pulled an all-nighter? That is, you've never stayed up late studying all night, let me say. So the next day came and you were still studying. Who'd never did that before? Abdullah?
Yes, me, because I'm studying step by step.
Yeah.
This is my method.
Yes, I would say do that. Study step by step every day, do a little, and then you'd be done. Good. So that's a good idea. Baskari, have your hand up.
Yes, doctor. I've never pulled an all-nighter. I feel like not sleeping at all is very bad for your health.
It's true.
So at least I would sleep like 3 to 4 hours. Even if I need to wake up early in the morning, I would still sleep for a little bit.
Okay, excellent. Thank you, Pascal, and thank you, Abdullah. That's a good idea. How about question two? What kind of study habits do you or did you do, huh? Or did you have as a student? That is, do you hit the books every night or do you cram at the last minute? What kind of person, just deal with this question. What kind of study habits do you do? Or did you do? Or did you have as a student? Let me tell you guys about me, and then we'll listen to Liqa. As a student, I remember mostly during my BA years, I had this habit of going to the library. So I was friends with the library, honestly speaking. So after my classes, I would go to the library. It was like my habit. I would go there for 3 hours before I would go home. And my mom always knew that, okay? So I would like review all that I took on that day. Can you imagine, guys? And so when I get home, usually I would like just, you know, chill around with my brothers and sisters and, you know, watch a movie. Sometimes I would do some studying, I mean, but most of what I had to cover was covered during the time I was at the library. And people at the library even knew me. They were like, they would know that I came, and I, you know, all the people that worked at the library knew me very well because it was my habit to go to the library every day, okay? And they would always be helpful if I looked for a book, you know, because sometimes I would want to prepare like before the teacher. And so I would look up information about any topic that that we would be having like the next day. So imagine that was me. And, you know, during my time when I was a BA student, when like we wanted to analyze a poem or, you know, a novel or some form of literature, because that was my major. We had to find a book and read the book. Can you imagine? So it wasn't as easy as today. Like you would look, you know, let me say a poem up or a novel up, you know, through Google or the internet, and you'd find information, you know, without going back to a book and to the library. That was just how it was a long time ago. And I would go through all that process as a student, you know, your age, in order to, you know, have something different, you know, to offer in class, so that, you know, if you do have something to offer, you're different. You're not like the other students who just, you know, who are just spoon-fed, right? Yeah. So I still remember all that. And sometimes I would photocopy the papers and bring them back to class so that I can share them with my friends. And, you know, yeah. And my professors would always be pleased because that was something extra that the majority of students did not do. All right. So it was really, you know, something nice and helpful. Yeah. But you know what, guys, I got 96 and 97 in my courses at that time, which, and during our time, it was hard to get a 96 and a 97 out of 100. Okay. So nowadays we have lots of students getting those grades, but are they as hardworking as, you know, students in the past? That's my question, guys. So me and my colleagues would sometimes discuss this and talk about this and say something like, you know what, we were so good. We did a lot of work, but we never got, you know, these grades that many students get, and they don't do as hard work as we did. You know, that's something that most, you know, professors talk about nowadays, you know, like students are getting very high grades, but are they really deserving of those grades? Are they as hardworking as we were when we were students? You know, got it? Now, a regular student would like get an A average, okay? While like in the past, a student would be so great and he would barely get, you know, a very good average, not an excellent one, you know? And their level would have been like, would be like a lot higher than those of today's students who get the excellent or the very good, you know, average. Yes, Asif, you have your hand up.
Yes, doctor. Actually, for me, it depends. If I like the course, I hit the book every night and make sure to prepare for the next lecture. But if I don't like, I hate the course, I cram at the last minute.
Yeah, that cramming is not a good idea. That is because you're really, because you punish yourself. It's, you already hate the course. You already dislike it and don't feel that comfortable with it. And then cramming makes it worse. Do you know that, Asil? Tell yourself that. It's all about, you know, what you tell yourself. It's all in your head, by the way, Asil. We think sometimes it has to do with something else, but it's not really that. You have to ignore everything else because you know what? The course doesn't care. The teacher doesn't care, you know, but you get infected. You get, you know, influenced negatively, you know, because of what you do, because of your daily practices. Yes, thank you, though. Liqa.
Yeah, doctor. I'm the kind of student that only hits the book with the most difficult subjects. But I also cram at the last minute with the easiest one. Like because I already take notes in the class and I focused at the class, so it won't be hard for me.
Uh-huh. It's usually not that hard. Okay, so you don't cram when it has to, I mean, like when it has to do with material that's difficult, but you cram, you know, material that has, that is easy, let me say, right? Because you think that you can handle it later on.
Yeah, doctor.
You have to handle, you know, easy material than to handle difficult material. Okay, thank you. How about the next section about tests? What is the best way to study for a test on idioms and expressions? You know, we're discussing lots of idioms and expressions, right? Hit the books. Those are idioms and expressions, guys, all right? That's what they're called, all right? So what is the easiest way to study them? Huh, Rewan?
Maybe practice like speaking these idioms with someone, like with a native speaker maybe, or like write them in sentences, look up their meanings.
Good.
Yeah, I think.
Yeah, that's right, Rewan. I would say that the best thing is to look up their meaning, first of all, to see what they mean in general, and then to, you know, like find them in actual sentences or in sentences actually spoken by people. So we can see, like, you know, what they actually mean and how they work in sentences, in different kinds of sentences, not just one sentence. I mean, like different sentences, like several sentences. Okay, not about the same topic, just because you want, you know, variety, right? So that you can know yourself how to use them on your own when you want to use them, right?
Yes.
Okay. The next section is, have you ever taken a test cold without studying, guys? If you explain the situation. A test, it could be a pop quiz, by the way. You know what a pop quiz is? Who knows what a pop quiz is? Pop. Yes, Rewan.
A quiz that a doctor or like teacher or anybody like gives to students suddenly during the class without short notice.
Yes.
In a short notice.
So probably listen, your teacher might ask you guys questions about something that she's asked you to prepare, and then you're not ready. And then she says, well, you know, come on. Take out your pen and paper. We're going to do a quiz right now. That's called a pop quiz, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I bet you would not like to take a quiz like that, right? Abdullah.
Yeah, just doctor, I want to say I took a test cold at the last semester on German. Yeah, because I told you before, my method is to study step by step. I don't like to hit the books once, you know, cram them all. So this is that happened to me.
So you took it cold because you crammed, you mean?
No, because I did study it step by step.
You didn't study step by step. So you felt that, but does that mean, Abdullah, that you didn't cover all the material? You didn't cover it all?
No, I covered.
Well, then how is that you took it cold? Taking it cold means that you didn't study at all.
Okay. No, doctor, I study it, but not, you know, not.
But you weren't ready. That's what you mean.
I prepared for it.
So you studied, but you studied at the last minute and you feel you did not collect enough information for the test. That's what you mean, right?
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, I understand. Yes, because you're right about that. It's always better to study step by step so that when you review the material before the exam, you know, it's, you know, it quickly pops out, let me say, and you can really make use of it, right? Yeah. Thank you, Abdullah, for sharing that. Has your mind ever gone blank during a test? Now, this is what you want to answer, Abdullah. Has your mind ever gone blank during a test? That is, you know, there were questions and you thought you knew them, you could answer them, but then suddenly the information was not available. Although you're super sure that you studied it and you covered it, but like when you needed the information, it did not come out. Did this ever happen to you?
Maybe on English language center tests, if you know it.
The 101?
No, not the one, 101. The one who TOEFL? I want to. What?
TOEFL?
And not the TOEFL, doctor. It's a language center test that when you apply for an Erasmus scholarship.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I have that one.
Yeah, there was a hard paragraph about science and stuff like that. So maybe.
Yeah, so you felt that you did not have information there available to discuss
actually,
talk about. Yeah. although it wasn't an impossible subject, but you just did not have enough, you know, knowledge about that.
Yes.
Something. Yeah. All right. Thank you for sharing that. If yes, explain what happened in your native country. Do teachers often give surprise pop quizzes? Guys, is this common in Jordan? Giving pop quizzes like when you were at school? Did your teacher ever say, you know, take out that pen and paper and come on, we're going to have a quiz right now. Right now. Did that ever happen, Rowan?
No, I don't think it's common, actually.
Well, I've done it many times to my students.
Okay.
All right. What is your opinion of surprise quizzes? It's like a punishment.
I actually like them. Like, personally speaking, I like them because, like, it keeps the student alert to, like, always be, like, always study, always be prepared, because you never know when this teacher will give a pop quiz. So
teachers like it for that purpose, by the way, but many students don't like it because, you know, they want to be prepared before the quiz. Yeah. But yes, it's a method of keeping the student, you know, let me say, alert, getting him to study all the time. Or, you know, it could, if it's too much, I would say some students would stop even studying at all, because they would like give up, lose hope. You know, if they've done several quizzes where they were not ready and prepared and did not do well, probably they'd give up on the whole, you know, course and material sometimes. Yeah. All right, next section. In your native country, so you have to know what pop quizzes are, okay, guys? They're quizzes that are given suddenly by teachers. Usually a teacher does it, you know, let me say, gives a pop quiz for two different reasons. One of them could be to see if you have prepared the material, okay? Another pop quiz could be because, you know, your teacher explained the lesson and she's done with it and, you know, there's some time left, you know, and she wants to see, like, what you learned or if you've learned what she's been, you know, teaching you, all right? So, or I just say she because I'm a she, all right? So it could be a he, right? I don't think all students like pop quizzes, all right? Rowan likes it, but I mean, some students really hate it. I never liked it as a student, honestly speaking, okay? But did I do it to my students? Yes, I've given them pop quizzes before, all right? In your native country, can students turn in their work late? If they can't turn their work in late, what is the penalty? That is, do they get a lower grade? Like, guys, last semester I taught a writing course, okay? And I gave students a specific time when, you know, like when to hand in their homework, or let me say their work, all right? Some students now cross the deadline. So I gave a deadline, like after this time, I'm not gonna take anything, all right? And then some students were like, you know, we didn't do it, you know, I don't know what happened, but then I gave them a whole week or 2 weeks to do it, okay? So when I got the quiz, I already said in my head without even looking at it, you know, minus two, that was the penalty. The penalty means like the punishment, okay? For not doing, you know, what you were asked to do during the time, okay? That you were supposed to do it. Because, you know, other teachers, you know what they would do? They wouldn't do minus two, they would just do zero. Got it? So you have to know what penalty means, all right? Penalty is like the kind of punishment. So if they can't turn in their work in late, would there be a penalty? Yes. Some students, like I said, some teachers, they would not take the, you know, the homework or the work late. Okay, they wouldn't accept it. They wouldn't accept, you know, to allow any student to turn it in late anyway. But some teachers, you know, are more lenient. They would take it in. But even when they would take it in, they would, give a penalty. Now, I don't know. There are some teachers who would be probably very nice. I don't know. Very lenient. I don't know if you call that nice. And they wouldn't, you know, even punish the student in any way. And that's it. He would be treated like any student who handed in the, you know, the work on time. Right? Like I told you, for me, the student would get a lower grade. And that's what I did. And one time, the student got very mad, like, oh, I worked for 2 days on it, but you handed it in late. Don't forget that. And I, you know, like mentioned it several times. And I told students that if you hand it in late, you're not going to get, you know, the grade. I'm not going to treat you like all the other students who handed it in, let me say, on time. All right. But, you know, some students still have hope that probably, you know, their teacher would like change her mind or his mind. All right. Let's move on to five. Who would like to read five for us?
Can I?
Yes, madam.
Five. Describe a situation in which you were or someone you know what you know was in hot water. What's happened?
Mm-hmm. Yes, madam. Do you want to tell us about that?
Yeah, I don't.
So, madam, describe a situation in which you were in hot water. Hot water means in trouble. Was there any situation where you were in hot water, like in trouble? Guess what, guys? Well, one time, me and my sisters and brothers were playing. When I was, of course, not, you know, that old. I was probably in the ninth grade, or I forgot exactly. Maybe not ninth grade, like, no, like in the sixth grade. And we kept on, you know, running after each other and playing. And you know what? And guess what we did? Guess what, madam, what we did? Yeah. We broke the TV. Okay. And we were all in hot water. We were not allowed to go out, you know, anywhere for a week. And then, you know, my mom and dad forgot about the whole issue and they let us out again. And, you know, things went back to normal. But like for a whole week, they were mad at us. That was like we were in hot water, right? They were mad at us. That means we were in trouble with them just because of what we did, because of our carelessness. Okay. Yeah. So for now, let's stop, guys. We should have stopped like 3 minutes ago anyway, but it's fine. Like I said, next time will be your midterm exam. Okay. Please make sure that you, you know, do your exam on time according to the university schedule. Okay. Pay attention to the midterm exam schedule. And like I said, guys, half of the time spend it on the grammar and vocab and the other half on listening. It's up to you. You can decide how much time you want to spend on each, all right? But you've done this kind of quiz and or exam and you've done that. So you know what to expect, okay? So I just want you to do well and I wish you all the best. And on Thursday, guys, there will be something to write, not a class, okay? So again, Sunday, live class. Tuesday, what? Listening quiz. And Thursday, something to write. That's how it will be. And according to that, that's how we're going to work with Ramadan.
So this Thursday, there will be something to write.
Yes. That's how it will be every time. And you can work on it over the weekend until Sunday comes. On Sunday, it won't be available. Okay.
Okay.
Yes, Abdullah, you have your hand up. Any question before we leave?
Just, doctor, I want to, the listening quiz is not be at the morning.